The town of Okene in the defunct Ebira division of the old Kwara state in north central Nigeria awoke on June 18, 1975, just like any other day. Nothing in the omens suggested that a child of destiny was about to enter the world. Everyone went about their daily chores and commercial activities proceeded as usual. For the family of Alhaji Bello Ikpemida Ochi, it was a day of expectation as the matriarch of the home had fallen into labor. Soon shouts of joy rent the air as a son was brought into the world. Yahaya, the sixth child of the family, had arrived. Despite losing his father and breadwinner at an early age, Yahaya's mother, Hajia Hawawu Oziohu Ochi, rose to the challenge. She raised all her children through smart work, sheer doggedness and sincerity, qualities she obviously passed on to Yahaya from his early days.
His Excellency was raised by his mother of blessed memory, of course with the support of his elder sister of blessed memory as well, Hajia Rabi. And of course, with the support of his elder brother, Professor Ilyas Ohiani. My mother-in-law, blessed memory, Hajia Awao Oziohu. Mama can be best be described as someone that was meek as a dove. She was gentle as a dove. Yet her greatest asset was her patience, her resilience. And she was also very courageous. And this combined, coupled with her empathy for humanity in general, helped shape and molded His Excellency into the man you see today.
In 1984, the young Yahaya proceeded to the local government education authority primary school, Agasa, and the journey of educational excellence began. He was made captain of his class in his second year, all through to the sixth year when he became head boy. He then moved on to the Agasa Community Secondary School, Anyava, Agasa, Okene, where he passed his junior secondary school examinations. He completed his senior secondary school education at the government secondary school, Suleja, Niger State, in 1994. After a diploma program at the Kaduna State Polytechnic in 1995, Yahaya Bello proceeded to the prestigious Ahmadu Bello University, Zaria, where he bagged a degree in accountancy. He capped it up with a master's degree in business administration in 2002.
When we met in Ahmadu Bello University, he came in to join us in 200 level as a direct entry student in accounting. When he came, since the first time he stepped his toe on the shore of the university, we became very close. And since that time to this point, the bond had been very strong.
His Excellency Alhaji Yahaya Bello was my classmate. We both graduated from Ahmadu Bello University Zaria in 1999. I remember those old good days when we were in the school. And in 1997, when they were conducting a NUASA election, and he just came in at the dying minutes and he almost won. So he has been an absolute politician from birth. He has been trying his best to ensure that he serves the people and serves humanity.
By 2004, he was a chartered fellow of the Association of National Accountants of Nigeria. Yahaya was posted to the Revenue Mobilization Allocation and Fiscal Commission for his mandatory year in the National Youth Service Corps in 2001.
Revenue Mobilization Allocation and Fiscal Commission. But we are aiming, see, because of our background, we are aiming to serve in CBN. Say no, that this place is better. It's better because we have somebody that is going to assist us.
His high work ethic and resourcefulness earned him a job at the completion of the exercise, and he went on to distinguish himself.
In 2001, as we are finishing our youth service, because of his commitment, because of his contribution to the commission, because he was in research and statistics, PRS, then I was in the allocation department, because of his contribution, because he stood among all the youth corpus that were sent to the commission. So he was recommended for detention. So at that time, I was already going to Lagos to join my uncle, who was a board member with Nigerian Port Authority. So he was already working and with the commission for his retainership. Then I was already on my way to Lagos for an interview. So as I was receiving my appointment letter, the same moment he was receiving his appointment letter in the commission.
His dedication and aptitude earned him rapid promotion within a short period, and he was transferred to the McCurdy branch to head the accounts department.
I was employed as accountant too, then as a young accountant, and he too was employed as accountant too with Revenue Mobilization and Allocation Fiscal Commission. So he was posted to McCurdy, and I was retained back in Lagos.
He rose steadily to the position of Assistant Chief Accountant before he resigned voluntarily to pursue his interests in the private sector. He successfully created an investment portfolio which cuts across oil and gas, banking, transportation, agro-allied business, and real estate. His business interests have created hundreds of jobs for youths in Kogi State and other parts of Nigeria. For the young Yahaya Adoza Bello, a world free of conflict and war is possible. For one who was drunk from the well of wisdom of Mahatma Gandhi, Mao Zedong, Lee Kuan Yew, Nelson Mandela, and of course, Muhammadu Buhari, this is no surprise. He believes that a world free of racism and war is possible, one in which love and selfless service would be the order of the day.
The best daddy and husband in the whole world. A very dogged politician. A great man of the people. A philanthropist. He is a wonderful man. When I say wonderful, not just to us as family, by extension to everybody that are close or far away from us. So he's a great guy, very, very wonderful man.
His Excellency is life to me. He's my father, my mother, my husband, my boyfriend, and a guardian angel to me.
Yahaya Bello displayed political shrewdness when he teamed up with a group of progressive young men and women to form a network known as Kogi Youth Arise Group. This platform mobilized youths from every ward in the state to support the candidature of Muhammadu Buhari in the 2015 presidential election. He also sought the ticket of the All Progressives Congress in the 2015 governorship race and came second behind the late former governor, Prince Abubakar Audu, in the primaries. The unfortunate demise of Prince Audu just before the announcement of the governorship election result thrust the mantle of leadership in Kogi State upon his young shoulders. He became the elected governor of Kogi State just before his 40th birthday, making him one of the youngest ever governors in Nigeria's democratic history. Yahaya Adoza Bello's emergence as governor of Kogi State is one that inspires great hope that competent, effective, and sincere leadership can come forth in Nigeria and birth the much-desired growth, progress, and prosperity. Indeed, the prospect of a prosperous Nigeria under the leadership of GYB, Governor Yahaya Bello, can clearly be seen in the peace and progress Kogi State is witnessing under his watch.